10 to 20 million Americans dies in a war with North Korea. A single intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, hitting a big American city will likely wipe out up to 1 million people, immediately or very soon after the thermonuclear bomb, H-bomb, has hit. North Korea has, which is an informed guess, around 50 ICBMs. It has already tested two of them and both tests were successful. On logical ground, we have to assume that there are plenty of them, if they already tested two and are in the pipeline for even more tests. North Korea has also, according to the Defense Intelligence Agency, which is the U.S. military's own intelligence service, 60 nuclear bombs. But also, this is a guess, North Korea can have more than that. Of these 50 ICBMs, it's more than likely that North Korea, as deterrence, already today, has around 25 ICBMs loaded with nuclear bombs, maybe more. If United States attacks North Korea in a so-called first or preemptive strike, it has no practical chance to knock out all these ICBMs, which are hidden under mountains and protected against all weapons, and exact where these ICBMs are located, no one in USA knows. Thus, if Donald Trump attacks North Korea, he is begging for retaliation. And that will come. So when North Korea sends 25 ICBMs against USA, it does not matter if USA is lucky to knock out one or two of them, which even that would be a feat due to the present standard of the anti-ballistic systems, which so far have been designed to success in tests, and even then often failed. Thus, if US takes out a couple of the Korean ICBMs, the rest, 20 plus, will kill about 10 to 20 million Americans. Needless to say, USA is then destroyed as a superpower and as a working state. The people in United States will suffer tremendous. So then, would it not be smart for the US administration to continue the diplomatic efforts instead for starting a war with North Korea? If you listen to Trump, he prefers a war over diplomacy, a war which will lead to tens of millions of dead Americans. Does it sound rational? Not very. If you are living in US, it's your choice. I don't see a mass movement against the war Trump talks about, so I guess the US public is totally brainwashed and are not realizing that an attack on North Korea would destroy not only North Korea, but USA as well. When the retaliation comes, and make no mistake, North Korea will retaliate because it has nothing to lose and it will make US pay dearly, and dearly it will be. So then, why it is your choice? Because only the people can stop the war maniacs, by starting anti-war protests. So what are you waiting for? For your own destruction? At last, you think my numbers are way off? In that case, ask any independent expert for a rejection. Let them tell you that North Korea has not the ability to hit US mainland and kill 10 to 20 million. After that, let me know who this so-called expert is, if you find him or her. I would then make a video about this rejection.